Well, it's a great honor, and I can't say how grateful I am for the honor of this award, and how delighted I am to share it with Ruslan, who is my favorite biologist almost, I have to say. He's a wonderful, wonderful scientist and person. Considering the issue of immigration, I remember my first exposure to science in America was when I was a freshman in college, and I was a biochemist. I decided to study biochemistry based upon my interest in, on the one hand, chemistry, and the other, biology as a high school student. It was a bit of a gamble, but it worked out, and I remember running into, in our small department at the University of Hull, as Tizia explained, I met our young faculty member. He must have been only there for a year or two, having finished his postdoc, and he explained how labs in America, where the hallways were paved in gold, and one could receive with a shopping cart, you could pick up all of the reagents and everything you needed to work. And this had made a big impression on me at the time. This was reinforced really by my postdoctoral mentors, both of whom, by the way, worked at NYU, Charles Weissman and Pete Borst, and they also kind of reinforced this idea that America was a marvelous place to work, even if you did have to put your child into a closet in your very small apartment in order to have them go to sleep. But I actually started in England, as you heard, and I think it was probably the food in Britain that drove me out. And I moved to the Netherlands. I worked with Pete, as you've heard, and migrated initially eastward to Switzerland to work with Charles. And then began a westward migration, actually. And I moved back to Holland. Teachers really explained that. I became a little mini faculty member and worked with wonderful, wonderful young people, which is the theme of what we do in science. Basically, having had good luck with that process, moved back to London, and thence to Boston. So it's basically westward. I went from Zurich, anyone who knows geography at least, westward from Zurich to Amsterdam to London to Boston, and finally to New Haven. And so, what is it? What is it that made a difference? And what is it that being an immigrant really means in any country, but especially this country, which is really to be an academic in America exposes one to truly gifted colleagues, people that really make a difference in one's work, and I can't think of anybody more gifted than Ruslan, in the quality of the young people that one has worked with, and I must say that of all of the things that I have done in my entire career, it is working with young people and seeing what they, who are almost all, by the way, immigrants in my environment, see what they have been able to do, to generate, and to make of their lives. That's been truly an inspiration and a delight. And then finally, the vitality of the general vitality of the American science system has been very exciting. One almost would say also the funding of the system of science in America. But unfortunately, in recent times, this has been somewhat in a situation of jeopardy. And I must say that unfortunately, and in recent years, I think it's not always been the case that all of the most talented people go into science, but then the good news is then that we still have the immigrants, and they keep flooding in, all of these marvelous people, just like the people who work with me now who come from countries like Colombia and from Israel and so on and so on. And this has been a tremendous inspiration. And then finally, the topic I chose to work on, which happened, the choice happened when I was in Britain, and it's truly extremely exciting to see how the study of what we call innate immunity now impacts everything that everybody in this room is doing and impacts all of the serious chronic problems that affect the Western, let's call it the developed world, and problems such as obesity, diabetes, neurodegeneration, and so on. These are, to a degree, all problems of the immune system, and it's so exciting to be able to work in these areas, to work with these young people, and to see both the sociologic impact on those people and the scientific impact. So thanks very much for the award. I can't tell you how much I appreciate it, and I apologize for going on for at least 20 seconds too long. Thank you.